The code we can write using NumPy is often shorter and more elegant than what we can write using base Python, but that's not the only advantage of using NumPy. Also, often the computations run much faster using NumPy. So let me show you an example of both of those in this video, both how the code can be shorter and how it can run faster. So I've already imported NumPy. Let me instantiate a new random number generator. So np.random.default.rng. And then these parentheses say make one of these random number generators and then save it as rng. And then I want to use the integers method of this random number generator object. And I'm going to be dividing by these numbers. So I want to make sure I don't include zero. So let's start at one. Let's just go 1 to 10, and let's say the size is 1,000,000. So this is a relatively small NumPy array, just 1,000,000 elements in it, 1,000,000 integers in it. And let's save it as the variable name ARR. And I want to contrast the NumPy version of these of this division that I want to do. I want to contrast that with the base Python list version of this computation. So let me turn this into a list. I'll say my list equals, and then I can turn ARR into a list using this list function. And let's just look at the beginning of ARR. Let's look at the first 5 elements in it. And the computation I want to do is 1.5 divided by each of these. And using the NumPy version, it's very easy. So I can just do 1.5 divided by this. So for example, I'm doing 1.5 divided by 3. Okay, that's the same as 1/2. So that's where the 0.5 comes from. Then I do 1.5 divided by 7. All the way at the end, I do 1.5 divided by 1. So that's where this one comes from. Okay, good. And so that is the NumPy version of this, just with the first 5. Let's see the list version of this. So if I do 1.5 divided by my list, okay, and then I'm using slicing to get the first 5 elements in my list, I get this type error, and it says, can't do float divided by list, okay? Even though it can do float divided by NumPy array. So that this is already one sign that things are easier using NumPy. How could I do this? I'd say the first way to think is, let's say, make a new list, okay, that's empty for now. And then for x in my list, :5, then we'll do one. We want to put something onto onto new list, so we'll do new list dot append 1.5 divided by x. And so at the end of this, I hope new list looks like the list version of these 5 numbers up here. Okay, let's check. Yep, looks the same. So you can see that this is quite a bit longer than the NumPy version. Oh, we saw a quick preview of list comprehension in an earlier video. Let me show you the list comprehension way of making new list. I can do 1.5 divided by x for, so the previous time we did for blank in range 10, something like that. Here, x, I mean, we'd just get an error and it would say x is not defined, or maybe x would be whatever the last version was up here. But I want x to be going through the elements. So, and notice how similar what I'm writing here is to this for loop version. So I was putting 1.5 divided by x onto new list. So that's the same as this 1.5 divided by x. And the for loop began for x in my list :5. And that's the exact same here for x in my list :5. And this whole thing is called list comprehension. And when I evaluate it, I get the exact same list. Okay, so this is definitely more elegant than the for loop version. It's also what's called more Pythonic, which is just like saying it uses some nice features of Python. That's the closest I want to come to giving a definition of the word Pythonic. So it's this list comprehension version. It's more Pythonic. but it still is longer than this 1.5 divided by the NumPy array. So that one is definitely the shortest. But let's see if the computations are actually any better. And here I'm going to go back to the full lists. So we'll do time it to time how long the computation runs. And so 1.5 divided by ARR. And the reason I made the NumPy array length 1 million instead of something like length 100 million is because one of these is very slow. And so it was going to take too long for the video if I had it be much longer than length a million. So this took 1.12 milliseconds, so about 1/1000th of a second. Okay, let's see how long this for loop version takes. So again, we'll do time it. And then want to make sure I get rid of the slice. So we're going through all 1 million elements. And an interesting thing about time it is at the end of this, I don't think new list is going to be what I'm making in here. I think this time it, you really only use it for timing. Don't expect this stuff to actually get persisted into future cells. So if you really want new list to change, you should run this again without being in the time it cell. So look at how much slower this was. It was over 1,000 times slower. So the array version, the NumPy array version, was much faster. And so I sort of expected that the list comprehension version, when I was first learning this material, I expected the list comprehension version would be much faster, like closer to NumPy than to this for loop version, but it's really not. So even though the list comprehension version is considered better in a sense, you shouldn't think of it as being significantly more efficient than the for loop version. So let's see how these compare. So right now it's running a few different loops. Guess it ran 7 runs, 1 loop each. So almost exactly the same. It's like within 1/10th of a second of the two. So you should imagine that the list comprehension version is more elegant, but you shouldn't imagine that it's a big improvement in terms of time over the for loop version. And you should imagine that the array version, the NumPy array version, is much faster. And my understanding is that there are two reasons the array version is faster. One is that in the array version, Python and NumPy know right away what the data type is of everything inside of ARR, so that speeds things up in a sense. And if you try this again with 1 divided by array, and similarly 1 instead of 1.5, you'll see that everything gets sped up, especially in the list version. So that's one reason the NumPy version is faster, is because Python does not have to check what is the data type of the 0th element in ARR? What's the data type of the first element in ARR? And so on. And another reason I believe this is faster is that the computations are what is called vectorized, which is saying that it's not going through each individually. It has a way of working with the whole vector of these numbers in ARR. It has a way of working with all of those at once rather than using a loop. And so that is called vectorization. And anytime you can use a vectorized version of a function, like in this case, we're using the vectorized version of division, you should, because it's usually going to be much more efficient to use the vectorized version over the loop version.